हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू राज मल्होत्रा आईएएस एकेडमी। आज का टॉपिक अगर हम बात करें एनवायरनमेंट एंड ज्योग्राफी में, वी गोना डिस्कस अबाउट एयर पोल्यूशन एंड व्हाट इज द रेलेवेंस ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इन आर यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन। लेट्स सी दिस। फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट एयर पोल्यूशन, रिसेंटली देयर वर टू आर्टिकल्स रिगार्डिंग एयर पोल्यूशन इन डाउन टू अर्थ मैगजीन। वन वॉज ओनली 25 सिटीज responsible for 52% of global urban greenhouse gas emission. So according to a study, there was like only 25 cities are contributing more than 50% of air pollution. And the other article says that Supreme Court mein jo Delhi government ne, they had given a petition, that petition about 10 thermal plant power plant to be shut down in NCR region. So because of these we are talking about एयर पोल्यूशन। बिकॉज आपको अगर पता हो, एनसीआर रीजन जो है वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पोल्यूटेड एरियाज, जो वर्ल्ड के मोस्ट पोल्यूटेड एरियाज में से एक है। और यहां पर अगर हम बात करें तो यहां पर हम एयर पोल्यूशन को कंट्रोल करने के लिए 10 थर्मल पावर प्लांट को शट डाउन करने की बात कर रहे थे। ओके तो इस वजह से आपका एयर पोल्यूशन जो है एक हॉट टॉपिक बन जाता है यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन के लिए। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट वी हैव इन दिस आर्टिकल। If we talk about air pollution, let's see the definition first. Air pollution refers to any physical and chemical or biological change. Any physical, chemical or biological change. What does it mean? Physical changes means that, for example, a dust particle is added to the air. That is physical change. Somewhere, if a chemical, for example, gases, toxic gases are released in the air, that is a chemical change. And when we talk about biological change, then certain bacteria, viruses added in the air, that can be contributing to air pollution. So these air pollution or pollutants, they are harmful gases or dust particles, smoke, which affects animal and human health drastically. Means that these things, a pollutant is one, pollutant कौन सा होगा जो आपकी health को या living entities की health को क्या पहुंचा रहा है, नुकसान पहुंचा रहा है। Otherwise उसे हम क्या नहीं कहते, हम उसको definition में count नहीं करते pollution की। So let's see what is pollutant first. We have talked about pollutant definition. Let's see what is pollutant. Addition of any undesirable material into environment, that is कहीं ना कहीं उसे हम क्या कह देते हैं, पॉल्यूटेंट। ओके, एडिशन ऑफ अनडिजायरेबल मटेरियल इनटू द एनवायरनमेंट, दैट इज नोन एज पॉल्यूशन। बट द एजेंट व्हिच कॉजेस दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम आर नोन एज पॉल्यूटेंट। ओके, द एजेंट व्हिच इज कॉजिंग इंपैक्ट और हार्मफुल इंपैक्ट ऑन द एनवायरनमेंट, दे आर कॉल्ड पॉल्यूटेंट। पॉल्यूटेंट कैन बी like I told you, physical, chemical or biological substance, which can be like directly or indirectly harmful for human health. For example, if we talk about water mein hum certain chemicals wagera hamara mix ho jata hai, like urea and all, that is not directly impacting the human health, but biomagnification, bioaccumulation can be there, which can lead to indirect impact on human health. So it can be directly impacting the human health or it can be indirectly impacting the human health. So agar aap pollution ke bare mein baat kare to pollution ka broad idea ye hai. Ab hum baat kare what are the major air pollutant. For example, if we want to talk about what are the major air pollutant, then sulfur dioxide can be one of them. Where we get this from? कहीं ना कहीं वॉल्केनिक इरप्शन से आ जाता है, कहीं ना कहीं आपके व्हीकुलर एमिशन से आ जाता है। सेम ऑक्साइड ऑफ नाइट्रोजन के साथ भी यही है, ठीक है जी। उसके बाद लेड आपका डायरेक्टली कोल गैस लाइक कोल हम बर्न करते हैं उससे आता है, थर्मल पावर प्लांट से। कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड आपका जब लाइक लिमिटेड सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन में आपका कोल वगैरह बर्न होता है या कोई भी फॉसिल फ्यूल बर्न होता है, दैट कैन लीड टू कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड प्रोडक्शन। ट्रोपोस्फेरिक ओजोन, इसके बारे में भी हम बात करेंगे, बट ट्रोपोस्फेरिक ओजोन इज हार्मफुल फॉर ह्यूमन, वेयर एज अगर हम बात करें दिस इज द बैड ओजोन, अगर हम बात करें तो देर इज अ गुड ओजोन टू, दैट इज इन द स्ट्रेटोस्फेयर। वो कहां पर है, स्ट्रेटोस्फेयर में। बट अगर हम इस ट्रोपोस्फेरिक ओजोन की बात करें, ये डायरेक्टली नहीं रिलीज होता, तो इसके बेसिस पे हम देखेंगे दो तरह के पोल्यूटेंट, वन विल बी प्राइमरी और अदर विल बी सेकेंडरी। बट इसको समझने के लिए वहां तक हमें पहुंचना पड़ेगा। अब सस्पेंडेड पर्टिकुलेट मैटर, लाइक वी टॉक अबाउट पीएम 2.5, पीएम 10, सो पर्टिकुलेट मैटर 10, 2.5, दीज आर इंजूरियस फॉर योर लंग्स, सो दैट्स व्हाई ये भी एक तरह से आपके किसकी कैटेगरी में आते हैं, मेजर एयर पोल्यूटेंट की कैटेगरी में आते हैं। और उसके अलावा एक बेंजीन आप और याद कर सकते हैं। तो दीज आर द मेजर एयर पोल्यूटेंट्स। लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ एयर पोल्यूशन। इफ वी टॉक अबाउट एयर पोल्यूशन, व्हाट आर द मेजर टाइप्स, फर्स्ट वन इज प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट, ठीक है जी, या प्राइमरी एयर पोल्यूशन। व्हाट इज प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट और प्राइमरी एयर पोल्यूशन, व्हेन a chemical is directly released in the air which causes trouble to human or like environment, then it is known as primary air pollutant. For example, sulfur dioxide is released in atmosphere when it combines with the water it causes production of what, sulfuric acid, and it results into acid rain. So it is directly impacting the human health, so hence it is a direct pollutant. But sometimes there are pollutant which do not directly impact us, they need a trigger point. For that you need to understand secondary pollutant, so what are they? They are like ki somewhere primary pollutant say they are like related. For example, if we talk about volatile organic compounds, when they react with sunlight they produce ozone gas. Okay, volatile organic compound, when they react with sunlight they produce ozone. This tropospheric ozone is like very dangerous. It impact our lungs, it can impact our like it can trigger asthma. So there are various health challenges associated with it. So that's why it is coming under the secondary air pollutant. It is not directly released, because for the formation of O3 we have to have volatile organic compounds and plus sunlight, then only it can be formed. So hence they are not directly released in the environment by the human activity. So if we talk about the next thing, that is about, if we talk about how we can divide air pollution, then on the basis of physical form air pollution can be particulate pollution, pollutant or gaseous pollutant. For example, when we talk about PM 2.5 or PM 10, these are the particulate pollutants, means they are physically solid in nature, whereas we talk about sulfur dioxide, we talk about nitrogen oxides, nitrate oxides and all, so that is nitrogen oxides and all that are covered under gaseous pollutant. So on the basis of physical existence or the physical form, they can be divided into solid or liquid, and hence solid mein aapke kya aage PM 2.5, 10, whereas aapke gaseous mein kya aage SO2, ozone gas, any form of gas which pollutes the air. Agar hum aage chale, to on the basis of cause the air pollution can be divided into two halves. One will be natural, which we gonna discuss in detail, and other gonna be anthropogenic causes. So on the basis of causes it can be of two type, natural or human made. Natural may, for example, the volcanic eruption releases a lot of toxic gases, so hence it is a natural source. Forest fire produces a lot of carbon dioxide, that can also cause a air pollution, or smoke, that can also cause a air pollution. If we talk about dust storm is also a kind of air pollution, because in this particulate matter has been increased in the air, So hence, these majority of these, like three major, these are the three major natural causes of air pollution. Okay, but inke upar hamara, if we talk about whether we can control this or not, so these natural source of air pollution, we do not have much control over them. We cannot stop volcanic eruption, we cannot stop dust storm, we cannot stop forest fire. But the thing is, we can do certain things which can help. For example, in dust storm area, we can plant more trees. That will somewhere reduces the air pollution, because when we have a lot of trees, which means that there will be lesser amount of erosion, and hence when wind erosion is eliminated, hence it will reduce the dust particle in the air. Whereas we can talk about like forest fire. The only thing is, natural forest fire code you can contain, but you cannot eliminate it. And same with the volcanic eruption. So let's see what is the next thing. Anthropogenic causes mein what we have. If we talk about anthropogenic causes, the first one, the foremost one, is burning of fossil fuel. For example, the thermal power plant which we have are coming under this burning of fossil fuel. So when we burn fossil fuel, it releases a lot of chemical gases like sulfur dioxide, oxides of nitrogen, then your carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. These kind of gases are released and which are harmful for air quality. If we talk about agriculture, for example, we grow paddy creates a anaerobic condition. Paddy creates an anaerobic condition in which we release, for example, jab hum rice ugate hain, to we full like, let's take this example. For instance, if this is a field, we fill this field with water, we submerge this land with water, resulting into anaerobic condition. This anaerobic condition, what it results into? It results into release of methane gas. So hence, if we talk about animal also produces methane gas. So animal husbandry can also be one of the reason along with agriculture. So these two things, you have to relate it with the anaerobic respiration taking place in the paddy field. Not every agriculture activity produces like air pollution, but some of them do produce it. So you have to relate it with that. Then if we talk about, we have talked about animal husbandry, agriculture, for fossil fuel. Now waste creates two kind of problem. One is, whenever this waste is like decomposing, it generates a lot of toxic gases, even methane. First point. The second point is odor, means the kind of smell, the pungent smell which is around the waste landfill, that also creates a lot of problem. So hence it causes two sort of problem. Now if we talk about automobiles, it is one of the prime reason of air pollution. Human made air pollution may one of the like one fifth contribution, one of the major factor, and one fifth of the contribution comes from automobile sector. For example, transportation sector B, if you want to quote it, you can quote it as transportation sector, because a lot of chemical gases like sulfur, nitrogen are released, nitrogen oxides are released from these sources. And if we talk about mining, it creates a lot of dust, hence one of the reason factories and mining activity is repeated twice, so we will eliminate this. So let's move to the next part. What are the impact of like air pollution? If we talk about, various organizations says that almost 7 million premature death worldwide annually are related to this. According to WHO, almost 2.5 million people loses their life just because of air pollution. It is one of the major reason for climate change, because a lot of toxic gases like methane, it causes a lot of global warming. So hence it can lead to global warming. But there is one more thing, like smoke particle, dust particle, if they settle down on snow, if they settle down on snow, it will reduce the albedo value. Albedo value is like ki aap ek tarah se ki how much sunlight is reflected by back by an object. So once the albedo value is declined because of pollutants, because of smoke or black carbon or brown carbon, then it will ultimately result into lesser amount of albedo, means more energy will be absorbed, and hence it can lead to melting of snow. Like we are facing this kind of problem in Himalayas. We have started an initiative, Secure Himalayas. Why we have started? Just to make sure climate change does not occur at a such a steady pace. So climate change is related with this. If we talk about water pollution, somehow related with it, because if we talk about rainfall pattern depends upon the air quality, and hence if global warming is increasing, means temperature is increasing, and if temperature is increasing, the rainfall pattern will become erratic, means it does not like ki follow the general pattern. That's why. And let's discuss other things in detail. Like if we talk about impact on human, so then it can cause what kind of problem? It can cause heart disease, lung disease, cancer, respiratory disorder, means asthma and all. Because if you know, smoke plus fog, it is very dangerous for asthmatic patient. So hence it can damage your lungs permanently. So respiratory disease se problem rahegi. If we talk about air pollution directly contaminate kar sakta hai aapka water bhi and soil bhi. How it can do it, or even it can kill the harmful it can kill the helpful organisms also. For example, if we talk about acid rain, somehow it is directly related with the quality of air. The third point talks about acid rain. So as I told you, your water plus sulfur gives you H2SO4. Means if the more concentration of H2SO4, means there will be acid rain. Around we can say 5.6 se niche jab bhi aapka pH level jayega, it can cause a acid rain. But many organisms, for example earthworm and everyone, they cannot survive in such a harsh condition. They cannot survive in such a harsh conditions. So that's why it can damage your yielding pattern. So, or even more, sometimes the pollutants are deposited in dry form. So that can cause a bearing of problem of desertification or problem of land becoming barren. So that's why these are related with each other. And the last one is global warming, which I have explained you. So what are the initiatives taken by the government? What are the things which government has done? So government has notified National Ambient Air Quality Standards. These standards should be followed by these are sector specific standards and should be followed by every industry as per their notification. And if we talk about, we have set up various monitoring network to assess the ambient air quality. Like we have done suffer kya hai, we are calculating the air quality. Somehow we are calculating the air quality so that people should be informed that these are the problems, and we have to work towards solving this problem. If we talk about, we have introduced cleaner gases like LPG, CNG, ethanol blending. Like aap bata sakte ho Gobardhan Yojana, that is also an initiative. If we talk about introduction of LPG, CNG, that is also a thing. Then you can talk about FAME scheme, which talk about electric vehicle, FAME 1.0, 2.0. So these are the things. Then we have National Air Quality Index. So these are the things which government has done. Like we have skipped altogether BS5 ko humne altogether skip kar diya, and now we are moving directly to BS 6, which has a lesser amount of like release of toxic gases. तो ये जो toxic gases थी उनका release का standard इसमें बहुत कम है. We will discuss about BS standards in one of the videos. But the thing is, BS is somewhere you can relate with Euro ratings. It is rating for vehicles according to their emissions. ठीक है जी. BS standards क्या है, भारत standard क्या है, भारत स्टेज क्या है, आपके व्हीकल की स्टैंडर्ड सेट करता है कि कितना एयर पोल्यूटेंट है वो और कितना नहीं. तो एज कंपेयर टू 4, जो 6 है उसमें जो पोल्यूशन का मार्जिन है दैट इज वेरी लेस. हेंस इट इज वेरी गुड थिंग. लाइक वी हैव बैन ऑन बर्निंग ऑफ बायोमास. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, पहले क्या होता था कि लोग घर के पास ही पत्तों को आग लगा देते थे. बट नाउ गवर्नमेंट सेज कि ऐसा नहीं करना है, उससे कंपोस्ट बनाने की बात होती है. तो कंपोस्ट स्कीम जो है लाइक गवर्नमेंट की कंपोस्ट स्कीम, दैट इज समवेयर आप रिलेट कर सकते हो इसी आप टॉपिक से. प्रमोशन ऑफ पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट नेटवर्क, दिस लाइक आपकी ये मेट्रो रेल्स, ठीक है जी, मोनो रेल्स, व्हाट आर दे आर जस्ट अ वे टू इंप्रूव द पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट, और जिसकी वजह से आप इसमें बेनिफिट ले सकते हैं. लाइक एयर पोल्यूशन घट सकता है. बिकॉज अगर हम बात करें, अभी मैं फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ अ सिंगल कार प्रोड्यूसेस 10 यूनिट ऑफ पोल्यूशन, फॉर एग्जांपल 10 यूनिट ऑफ पोल्यूशन, एंड अ ऑफिस कंटेन 4 पीपल एंड पोल्यूशन विल बी 40 यूनिट, व्हाट इफ दे स्टार्ट having, they are coming from a similar area, nearby area, what if they start doing carpooling? So somewhere the pollution will be limited to the 10 unit only. So it will be a energy saving practice too, but also somewhere we can regulate the amount of pollution which is going into the atmosphere. Then pollution control certificate, then we have like 17 highly polluted industrial area mein we have like 24/7 monitoring system, then we have passed air act in 1981, then we have like regulating the bursting of cracker during Diwali, we are using eco-friendly crackers and various other like graded action plan, response plan for Delhi. For example, they have 5-6 category of air where we have like 0 to 5, 0 to 50, 50 to 100, so many things are given. But the thing is, are they sufficient? These measures has been taken, हमने ये सब कुछ किया है, ठीक है जी. पूरा ये हमने देखा 3 पेजों का खाका जिसमें गवर्नमेंट ने बहुत सारे इनिशिएटिव लिए. आर दे सफिशियंट? प्रॉब्लम कहाँ है? अगर हम प्रॉब्लम की बात करें तो प्रॉब्लम ये है कि एक तो इंप्लीमेंटेशन, फॉर एग्जांपल वी हैव क्रिएटेड दिस स्टैंडर्ड्स नेशनल एम्बिएंट एयर क्वालिटी स्टैंडर्ड्स, बट द थिंग इज आर इंडस्ट्रीज, आर दिस सेक्टर्स फॉलोइंग दिस नोटिफिकेशन और नॉट? तो द थिंग इज, मेजर थिंग इज इंप्लीमेंटेशन. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट BS 4 and 6. ओके, द थिंग इज BS 6 के मैं आपको एक एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ. चंडीगढ़ में क्या हुआ था कि लाइक BS 4 बंद होने वाला था, तो दिस ऑटोमोबाइल डीलर्स हैव गिवन ग्रेट डिस्काउंट एंड पीपल वर रेडी टू बाय दीज थिंग्स ऑन डिस्काउंट बिकॉज दे डोंट केयर अबाउट देयर हेल्थ, ऑल दे केयर अबाउट सेविंग मनी. सो हेंस देर इज अ इशू लाइक दिस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ब्लेंडिंग ऑफ इथेनॉल, वी आर सेइंग दैट वी विल डू 5%, 10%. द एक्चुअल फिगर इज शॉकिंग. वी आर नॉट एबल टू अटेन विच द एम विच वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. द थिंग इज स्टिल अ लॉट नीड टू बी डन. द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज समवेयर लैगिंग बिहाइंड. सो अ कोलैबोरेटिव एफर्ट मीन्स, जैसे कि हमने स्वच्छ भारत अभियान में किया था, फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्वच्छ भारत अभियान, यू कैन रिलेट इट विद दिस बिकॉज स्वच्छ भारत अभियान प्लस टॉक्स अबाउट वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट. यू कैन टॉक अबाउट दैट ऑल्सो हियर. बट द थिंग इज, जैसे कि इस स्वच्छ भारत अभियान में वी हैव मेड इट एज अ जन आंदोलन, ठीक है जी, मास मूवमेंट, जन आंदोलन और मास मूवमेंट, वी हैव टू डू सर्टन थिंग्स So that air quality or air which we breathe, which is basic human right, right to life ka sabse bada part hai, ki you should have a clean air. Article, agar hum 21 ki baat karein, article 21, if we talk about right to life, आप कहीं ना कहीं डायरेक्टली रिलेट कर सकते हैं क्योंकि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने भी कहा है दैट यू हैव अ राइट टू हैव अ क्लीन एयर. सो कहीं ना कहीं अगर हम इससे रिलेट करते हैं तो हमारे को अगर अपने एब्सोल्यूट राइट को एंजॉय करना है, इसको एब्सोल्युटली एंजॉय करना है इस राइट को, तो वी हैव टू डू सर्टेन थिंग्स सो दैट इट बिकम्स अ मास मूवमेंट एंड अवेयरनेस जनरेशन शुड बी देयर. लाइक स्टूडेंट्स को, लाइक आप बच्चों को ये चीज पढ़ा सकते हैं, सिलेबस में इंक्लूड कर सकते हैं, आप राइट प्रैक्टिसेस इंक्लूड कर सकते हैं, लाइक स्विचिंग ऑफ द अननेसेसरी लाइट दैट कैन सेव एनर्जी. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ वी टॉक अबाउट एनर्जी, ऑलमोस्ट 50-60% ऑफ इंडियन एनर्जी सेक्टर्स एनर्जी कम्स फ्रॉम थर्मल पावर प्लांट. सो इफ वी टाइमली टर्न ऑफ द लाइट्स दैट कैन सेव एनर्जी, that can save energy. Hence, energy तो बचेगी बचेगी, air quality भी बचेगी. तो कहीं ना कहीं हमें इसे एक mass movement बनाने की जरूरत है, awareness create करने की जरूरत है. तो आज का article, I hope अगर मैं इसमें आपको कभी question आ जाता है इससे related, तो आप इसको बहुत आसानी से, like आपको उसमें government के initiative वगैरह बताने की जरूरत थी, जो भी चीजें cover करने की जरूरत थी, that we have covered. Most of the things we have covered in this lecture. So I hope you did like this lecture. ऐसे interesting lecture के लिए आप हमारे को subscribe कर सकते हैं. Do watch us on Raj Malhotra IAS Academy. Thank you very much.